हेलो चिल्ड्रन, दिस वीडियो इज फॉर क्लास टू, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स, टॉपिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग थ्री डिजिट नंबर्स, एंड आई एम योर मैथ्स टीचर प्रियंका बेस्ट। चिल्ड्रन, कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द नंबर वन मोर देन 99? व्हेन 1 is added to 99, the sum is 100. So children, after 99, the counting number is 100, and this is a 3-digit number. Children, 100 is the first and smallest 3-digit number. 100 is the first and smallest 3-digit number. Children, 3-digit numbers are from 100 to 999. 3-digit numbers are from 100 to 999. Now children, let us understand what is a 3-digit number. Children, in 3-digit numbers, the digits are placed at ones, tens, and hundreds place. At the extreme right of the number, there is ones place. Then, to the left of it, there is tens place. And to the left of it, there is hundreds place. The digits have their place value in a given number. Children, look at the example. Here, 265 is a 3-digit number. Here you will see that 3 digits are there, which are placed at ones, tens, and hundreds place. You will see that 5 is at ones place, 6 is at tens place, and 2 is at hundreds place. So children, here 265 is a 3-digit number. Now children, let us see how will you read 3-digit numbers. So children, first read the hundreds. First read the hundreds, then read the last two digits together. Then read the last two digits together. Children, it means first read the digit which is placed at hundreds place. Then read the tens digit and ones digit together. So this is the way how we read 3-digit numbers. Now look at the examples, children. Here you will see a number. So how will you read this number? Look at the first number, children. There are 3 digits placed at ones place, tens place, and hundreds place. So now let's see how will you read this number. First children, you will read the hundreds, that is the number at hundreds place. Then you will read the last two numbers, last two digits together, that is the digits at ones place and tens place. So you will read this number as 345. Now children, here 3 is at hundreds place, so there are 3 hundreds. 4 is at tens place, so there are 4 tens. And 5 is at ones place, so there are 5 ones. Now in expanded form, you will write it as 300, that is 300, plus 4 tens, that is 40, plus 5 ones, that is plus 5. Now children, look at the second example. Here, how will you read this number? 630. First you will read the hundreds, then you will read the last two digits together. Now children, in 630, you will see that 6 is at hundreds place, so there are 6 hundreds plus 3 tens plus 0 ones. So in expanded form, you will write it as 600, that is 600 plus 30 plus 0. Now children, let's do some questions given on page number 33 of your maths book. Question 1 fill in. Look at the first part children. Here the number is 273. Children, here you have to fill the blanks with the help of the place value. So children, according to the place value of the digits, you will fill the blanks. Now look at the first part. 273. Here children, you will see that in 273, 2 is at hundreds place and 7 is at tens place and 3 is at ones place. Okay children, so here you will write 200s plus 7 tens plus 3 ones according to their place value. Now children, in expanded form you will write it as 200, that is 200 plus 7 tens are there. So you will write 7 tens means 70 plus 3 ones. So you will write it as plus 3. So this is the expanded form of 273. Now look at the B part children. The number is 342. So you will see that 3 is at hundreds place, 4 is at tens place, and 2 is at ones place. So in the blank you will write 300s plus 4 tens plus 2 ones. Now in expanded form you will write 300s, that is 300 plus 4 tens means 40, 40 plus 2 ones. So plus 2, 2 ones means 2. So 300 plus 40 plus 2 is the expanded form of 342. Now children, next part C, 406. Here 4 is at hundreds place, 0 is at tens place and 6 is at ones place. So children, here you will write 400s plus 2 tens plus 6 ones. And in expanded form, you will write it as 400, that is 400 plus 0 plus 6 ones means plus 6. Now look at the D part. Here 873. The number is 873. So you will write the number as 8 hundreds are there plus 7 tens plus 3 ones. And in expanded form you will write it as 800, that is 800 plus 7 tens means 70 plus 3 ones means plus 3. So this is the expanded form of 873. Now children, next E part, the number is 997. Here in the blank you will write as 9 hundredths plus 9 tens plus 7 ones. And in expanded form you will write it as 9 hundredths means 900 plus 9 tens means 90 plus 7 ones means plus 7. So 900 plus 90 plus 7. This is the expanded form of 997. Now children, F part, 650. So here you will see that digit 6 is at hundredths place and digit 5 is at tens place and 0 is at ones place. So you will write it as 6 hundredths plus 5 tens plus 0 ones. Now in expanded form you will write it as 6 hundredths means 600, that is 600, plus 5 tens means 50 plus 0 ones means 0. So 600 plus 50 plus 0. This is the expanded form of 650. Now children, G part, the number is 544. Here you will see that digit 5 is at hundredths place, 4 is at tens place, and again 4 is at ones place. Now children, so you will write it as 500 plus 4 tens plus 4 ones. Now in expanded form you will write it as 500 means 500 plus 4 tens means 40 plus 4 ones means 4. So you will write it as 500 plus 40 plus 4. This is the expanded form of 544. Now children, H part, the number is 298. Here 2 is at hundredths place, 9 is at tens place, and 8 is at ones place. So children, you will write it as 200 plus 9 tens plus 8 ones. And in expanded form, you will write it as 200, that is 200 plus 90, that is 90, 9 tens means 90 plus 8 ones, 8 ones means 8. So 200 plus 90 plus 8, this is the expanded form of 298. Now children, I part, the number is 709. So here you will see that 7 is at 100 place, 0 is at tens place, and 9 is at ones place. So you will write it as 700s plus 0 tens plus 9 ones. Now in expanded form you will write it as 700 as 700 plus 0 tens means 0 is there plus 9 ones means plus 9. So 700 plus 0 plus 9, this is the expanded form of 709. Now children, do this question in your book. Now children, this question is your homework. In this question, abacus is given and beads are there. So with the help of beads, you have to fill the blanks. Okay? So do this question in your book. Thank you.